Hey everybody, welcome back to the creek.
Creekside
Maples. A lot going on today. We've got our new Meat King broiler chickens that came in today. We did not know they were coming today. It was a huge surprise. So we're going to share all that with you in just a few minutes. So what happened to us today? Well, a lot. We had ordered some Meat Kings, some chickens.
Take it right up to the camera.
And but we did not know that they were arriving today. So we found out they were, and
they are so
what happened?
Cute. Get down, Ruby.
Sit. What happened was we had ordered 24 and we come home with 44 because they had extras. So now we have 44 meat chickens that we need to make room for. So we are going to put them all in our brooder pen here. And if you don't know about our brooder pen, I built this last year. There's a video for it. I'll put a link up to it. And how we built it and everything. And this is where we started our chickens off in. So we're going to put them all in here and get them settled in. They've been in these boxes long enough. Get away. They're cute little fellers, but they sure do get ugly as they get older.
Yep.
Now these little guys, I'd like to say that they'll all turn out good and healthy, but you never know from what hatchery you get them from or anything, so you just have to try to keep them as healthy as possible, comfortable, warm. That's all you can do. But they're definitely not very big at first. They're over here drinking already. I don't know how I got that sawdust in that already, but
oh, they likely did. I'm sure they did it.
They're drinking. So that's that bunch. Now we got another bunch. They're all doing good. Come on. There you go. So we got 44 here. Where we buy them at the co-op feed store. When I went in today, they asked me if I wanted to buy more because they had more. They had like 90 left over that I guess somebody had ordered 100 and canceled the order. And so now they were just sitting there trying to find a place for the chickens, for the Meat Kings.
We are not going to keep 44 in this little brooder pen.
No.
For a couple of weeks while their feathers are coming in. This one was only designed to hold about 20 comfortably. So you have other plans since our chicken number has doubled.
Yeah. Yeah, well, this will hold them for the next 3 or 4 days because they're just small.
Sure.
You know, and truth be told, they're probably fine in here for the first week, 2 weeks. That'll win just a whipping. But what I'm going to do is just over here in the barn, I'm going to build a pen right here. I don't know if you can see it or not, but it'll just come out here right on the floor. And it'll be probably like 6x6 or 5x5 or something like that. We'll build it up 8 inches. That'll keep them in. And then we'll put a little cover over the top to keep them warm. Something we can remove during the day, because in this barn, the sun comes through really good, and it's almost a greenhouse, and it keeps it nice and warm in here. And the chickens, the little chicks, need it to be about 80 degrees. So it'll be just comfortable for them. Yeah. And that's what we're going to do, and that'll give them lots of space to live in. And then when they leave the brooder pen, we have our chicken tractor, which is another video. You can go to our video library and or playlists or whatever, and you'll see there on our channel where I'm building the chicken tractor. And that's what they graduate from, this one into the chicken tractor. Why don't I just post a link and you can take a look at that video. Ruby is all infatuated with these new chickens. These little chicks, little fur balls. I'm not sure if she just wants to check on them or if she thinks they're candy. Something to snack on.
Well, Ruby has been a mama. She had a litter of 12 pups 5 years ago, and this is one of her pups, Jade, that we kept. So she's got that mama tendency, I think.
So they're just talking it all over around the water fountain right now. We've got some shavings in the bottom for them to hang out in. And now the bottom of this brooder pen is rubber. It's a rubber mat, and that keeps it so the bottom doesn't rot out and get all icky and wet and everything. When we build our new chicken coop, because we have 21 chickens now, and I've got 6 more coming, so we'll end up with like 27 chickens. And so our chicken coop, it can handle 10, 12 pretty easy, but when you get up to that many chickens, we don't have enough space in there for them. So we're actually gonna jack the chicken coop up, open the floor up a bit so they can come and go underneath of it, and then have a chicken run as well. And tack onto one end of it. We're going to turn it and build onto the end of it another 6 feet to enlarge your chicken coop. That's another project we got coming right up too. So lots of things happening here on the creek. So there are our new meat kings. All ready to grow fat. So I will.
Fat and fast.
Fast. They grow fat
they
fast.
They grow so fast, yeah.
In 2 weeks, they'll have all that yellow off of them. They'll have little feathers, and you won't even hardly recognize them. So I'm pretty sure, by the rate they're going at the water, that we need to get the other water thing going.
She's growling at me, dear.
Ruby.
She's growling
Ruby.
At me.
Ruby. Ruby thinks she's going to protect them.
She's thinking I'm going to hurt them. That little one's hanging right on.
Yeah, going for a ride. See, I'm thirsty. I'm out of here. Hey guys, hang on to the edge. This is our trip out of here. Mom, we can do this.
Chicken run.
Now more of them can drink.
Yeah.
They're thirsty. You're diving right in. All right. Look, he's looking up at me. Hey, dude, can you send us down some food?
Yeah, they did.
Is that right?
And this is just a chick starter mash. All it is. But once they get started and growing, they'll go through a bag of food, two bags of food a week, easy. That's when it gets expensive to keep chickens. But that's all right, because we're going to keep, out of these 44, we'll keep 20 and we'll sell the rest. 24 we'll sell. We've already got people that have put their names in for chickens, so it's all good. I like it when we have pre-orders.
Yeah, definitely.
And when we sell the chickens, they're all done up very humanely, dispatched very humanely. They're cleaned in a very sterile environment and weighed, put on ice, put in bags, and then put in the freezer. So it keeps them looking good, keeps them, you know, good food, good clean food. And if you keep chickens, you'll know what this is for. But if you don't, this little thing up here, it's just so that they can't balance on top of it. It keeps turning, and it discourages them from roosting or sitting on top of their food tray. That is the arrival of the Meat Kings.
Mm-hmm. Chick days.
Chick days here at Creekside. So we're going to go get work on some other projects. I don't know if we're going down the sugar shack or... I don't know. The wind is blowing really hard today. Yeah. I want to clean up the backyard. There's a bunch of stuff there that needs to be burnt. And everything from the winter. But we'll see.
It's anyway. Kind of windy to burn, though.
Yeah, but we do small fire, and the fire pit should be okay.
Here we go.
Thanks for watching. We'll be back. See you on the next video.
Take care. God bless. Thank you for stopping by our homestead. And remember, the best thing you can do is to share our videos.
Oh, yeah. Share, share, share. If your name is Sunny, you'll enjoy Sunny and Cher.
You're so cute.